Hi, welcome to NOP 221, Advanced Operational Systems. I'm Jason Stone, and I'm going to be your professor for the next 12 weeks. So if you haven't already done it yet, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel so you get notifications anytime I upload a new video. So in this course, what we're going to get into are, well, like the title says, the advanced operational systems. We're going to apply the theory of everything we've learned so far, all the thermodynamic fundamentals, all the logic theory, what redundant systems are, what safety features mean, what trip systems and interlocks do, and we're going to apply all that to actual systems. Say, if you've looked at the course already, you'll see that we're going to go over the very specific systems in a thermodynamic Rankine cycle. So we're going to look at the condensate, storage, and transfer system. We're going to look at the feed system. We're going to look at the reactor. We're going to then, how do we get the steam out of the reactor? What the turbine does, how it works. We're going to go out the electrical end of it. So where the turbine spins the generator, how is it actually making the electricity, and then how we transfer that electricity to the grid and to the systems in our own power plant. And then we go back into the recovery loop on that Rankine cycle, and we go through the condenser, back to the condensate storage and transfer system. So we're going to focus very specifically on those. This first one is AC distribution. This is all the electrical systems that we use. There's going to be some very, very strange terms that you're going to need to get used to really fast. Video. You'll see that on Module 2, we're going to do a Zoom meeting instead of me doing and uploading a video. I haven't done those before. Most of you had me for at least 2 classes, so this will be kind of a new thing for me, but I'm going to try and dedicate 2 hours next Monday night, about this time, 6 p.m. Monday. We'll sit down, we'll do a Zoom meeting, we'll talk about that AC electrical distribution system, get you into the material, but don't wait to get into the material. You'll see in the module list that I've pre-published all the materials for every single module: AC distribution, DC distribution, the condensate, the generator, the turbine. All these systems that we're going to go over are already out there. So some of you are going to be a little overwhelmed. Well, you know, on 1 week it's a 97-page textbook. Yep. And that's, to give you some perspective, when we're training the operators at the plant, we usually do 1 or 2 systems a day, which means the operators are required to absorb a 97-page manual and in about 3 or 4 hours, and then they get a break, do lunch, and then we do another system. So we're breaking up over 12 weeks what operators would get over about 4 days, maybe 5 days. All that means is that I know you can do this. I've seen operators, even if they struggle a little bit at first, I know you can get this, and that's what I'm here to help you. Give you some of those tips and tricks. What do you need to get out of this? What do you need to understand? And I can help guide your focus so you're not trying to memorize all 97 pages, but trying to understand what's important from them. To that end, at the back of every one of these texts is a list of learning objectives. I know that in some texts, learning objectives are kind of, well, students don't tend to care about those. But I'll tell you, they matter in these texts. We use these at my job. These are the actual learning objectives that the non-licensed operators use when they're going through these materials. And all the exams and materials are based on those learning objectives. So pay attention to them. Now, generically, there's a set of generic ones. You got to learn the purpose, you got to learn this flow path, you got to learn the nomenclature, you got to understand all the components and how they work together, system interrelationships, trips, interlocks, safety set points. Those are the generic overview big ones that always apply to all systems. So I've rambled a little bit here, but I think you've got a good start on what to do. Use this first week to start looking at AC distribution and even DC distribution. If you have questions, use the questions for the professor discussion link. I'll usually respond within a day or two. stay up on the announcements. I communicate to the class through announcements a great deal. So if you haven't already looked at the first couple announcements and done the task I put in the first announcement, be sure to go do that. We're going to use the module tab on the in Canvas to navigate through the course again. I think that's worked out for the other classes. I haven't gotten any bad feedback on that. So pay attention to the module tab. You'll see most of the stuff should be loaded and published at the start of every week, meaning by noonish on Monday. And then finally, one new thing we're going to do this module is I haven't typically done a midterm. We're going to do a midterm and then a final exam. And these are going to be bigger exams than what you've seen in these other classes. So with that, I look forward to seeing everybody in class. I look forward to seeing your work. All right, take care. What else do I need to tell them?